coming to you from New York City. Bringing the video podcast for global Filipinos around the world. Watch and listen as we speak and get to know different celebrities, icons, influencers, and inspiring people. Join Jesse Dang and Jay Cass as they talk about anything and everything while bridging the gap between Filipinos of different generations and genres of choice. This is Over a Glass or Two.
Ah, ayan na naman yung...
Hello, Jay Cass. Kumusta na? Aba, ang lola mo naka-sleeveless. Kumusta? Kumusta naman?
Oh my God. Jesse, you did not get the memo. Kailangan naka-sleeveless ka.
Ay, no, ang lamig eh. Winter pa rin din. Maluka ka naman. Magsisleeveless.
Ay, nako.
Ang lamig-lamig.
Pero wag natin ibaba yung camera kasi ayaw niya makita na hanging po siya.
Oo. So, naka-midrip eh.
Di hanging. No, hanging talaga siya. Hanging yung... Ano ko, crop top sa hello.
Kaya ka midrip? Ah, talaga? O ba? Talaga naman pa-sexy ka tonight, ha?
Yes.
Hi, nako. Ano, sabi ko nga, kinakabahan ako dito sa special guest natin ngayon. Kasi ano to eh, haligi ng pelikula ng mga, ng Filipino pelikula. Ano ba tapos? What is the right term for that?
Haligi ng Philippine movies.
Philippine movies, no? Gusto kong tagalugi na straight eh, bro. Diba, imagine? Talagang... Sko icon, talagang ano to, idol icon.
Saka ano, kaya, oh my God, sa prep natin, di ba matalino to? Naku, mukhang mapapalaban yung utak ko dito.
Sira ka talaga. I know, right? At least marami na naman tayong matututunan. Kaya gusto ko tong show natin eh. Kasi di ba, parang, I love, you know, picking their brains, no? Para may baon tayo sa future.
Kaya iba-ibang personality yung nakakasalamuha natin.
Correct, correct, correct. Pero sandali, ready ka na ba? Malapit na mag-springtime. Ay, I cannot.
Ready na, syempre.
I know, malapit na. So anyways, sige na po. Introduce ko na ang ating special guest for this morning kasi I'm sure marami nang nag-aabang. Ayan. Our guest for this morning is a media personality that has been working incessantly behind the scene to uphold the quality of our beloved Philippine movies. He has governed over ABS-CBN's film archives for years and initiated its film restoration project. He's adding another feather to his cap nowadays as a new co-host of FYE Channel's Best 10 Bets with Butch Francisco. May interview din po namin si Butch Francisco very soon. Let's get to know writer, editor, producer, director, film restoration advocate, and host, Mr. Leo Katigbak! Woohoo!
Hello, hello, hello. Good morning to Pamela. Good evening to you guys. Igit na igit ako sa inyo. I haven't been to New York in like 6 years already. So I will live vicariously through you guys. So I'm hoping to return there. One of my favorite cities.
Ay, nag-freeze. Ayan. Sir Leo, nag-freeze. Oo.
Ito kasi yung kanyang pananalig na mapunta ng New York.
Sir Leo, nag-freeze ko.
Oo nga. Anong nakuha niyo doon sa sinabi ko? Wala?
Oo, yun lang. Parang favorite mo New York. And that's it.
And that's it.
Okay.
Yes. I miss the pizza. I miss the bagels.
Oh,
I miss the energy.
The energy, no? So, I'm sure you've been around, no? Dami-dami mo nang puntahan sa buong mundo. Ano favorite place mo, New York?
Well, New York will always stand out, eh. Parang, to me, that's always had memorable experiences because I was there so often. But a lot of other cities, like recently, I just came from Buenos Aires. I also came from Antarctica. And those were great experiences as well. So,
oh
so maganda, maganda pumunta doon sa mga lugar, lalo na yung hindi masyadong pinupuntahan ng ibang tao.
Sa bagay, no? Lalo na Antarctica. Oh my God. Oh. Dream
di
na
ba tayo nakapunta doon, Jesse?
Sa inyo, mas madali lang kasi sa akin, it was door-to-door to Buenos Aires, was like 37 hours. Sa inyo, madali lang yun kasi from New York, you can fly down to South America already. It's not gonna be that long. Ako, siguro, I was flying for a day and a half.
Oh my God!
Eh kasi naman, siguro, eh kasi naman Leo,
sa bucket list.
Dito kasi naman sa New York, parang ano eh, parang Antarctica na sa lamig. Bakit pa ako pupunta doon sa mas malamig?
Nung pumunta kami ng Iceland last year, we were like, bakit ba tayo pumunta dito sa malamig na mas malamig? Pero it's okay, kasi it's a different
no.
scenery, di ba? Oo.
We love Iceland.
I know, my God.
Parang J-Cast, parang may nangyari sa Iceland, kaya mahal na mahal mong Iceland.
Parang ay, marami.
Ay, bakit?
Ay, paano mo nalaman?
Magaling ka talaga, Leo.
I'm between the lines.
Ang galing mo. Ang sinasabi ko lang yung scenery ng Iceland sa labas. Pero maganda rin yung scenery dun sa hotel ko sa hotel room.
I'm sure. Kaya pa ganyan na look mo ngayon with a hat and sleeveless?
I know.
Oo, kasi I feel sexy. Wow.
Alam mo, feeling ko, pag once
nothing na... wrong with that.
Exactly. Feeling ko, pag pumunta ka dito ng, ano, ng New York, tapos nag-dinner tayo, parang kulang a whole day, no? Sa pagkwentuhan.
Probably.
So, kasi nga parang feeling ko you're the type of person that would really talk maraming kwento. Eh, kami din ni J-Cast. Alam mo yun, pagbalik mo dito, ha? Wag mo kami makakalimutan, ha? Sir Leo, ha?
O, ayan, magsawa kayo sa... Pero no, I will. I'm hoping I can go sometime this year. And yeah, it'd be great to catch up in person, face to face.
Let us know, ha? Promise, ha? Teka, sige. Okay. So bago tayo mag-start, meron kami kaiklatan dito. Siyempre, we have to welcome you. Ayan, sana nga, wine eh. So, anong iniinom mo ngayon? Yan! Ayan! Oh, sige. Okay.
Masyado kong maaga for wine eh.
Oo nga, if for wine, no? Sayang. O kami naman, bawal na eh. TFC
mga,
kasi
mga wholesome na tayo ngayon.
Anyways, wholesome na kami. Wholesome na. So anyway, sige, let's welcome. Okay, sa Sambayan ng Pilipinas po at sa aming dearest USA. Guys, let's all welcome Mr. Leo Katigbak. Welcome to
Over a Glass or Two.
Cheers.
Thank you very much for having me.
Mm. Naku naman, si J-Cast naman yung nag-freeze.
Ayan,
bumalik na.
Kasi nag-ano
ayan,
tayo eh, nag-cheers
isang
tayo.
Isang photo op, tapos kwentuhan na tayo. Okay, yan. O sige. Okay. 1, 2, 3. Ayan.
Madalan niyo sa akin, ha?
I know. Alam mo, sobrang, hindi ko alam kung saan mag-uumpis. When I was reading your profile, sabi ko, my God, talagang, aligi ka nga talaga ng pelikulang Filipino. Ganun
para
katagal.
Sinabi mo, matanda na ako talaga.
Hindi ah. Baka ano, talagang ano lang, nag-start ka lang nung bata, like what, 20 years ago? Is it?
Well, Jesse, I turned 60 in a month.
What?
Wow. Yeah, akala ko. I thought you're only like 50?
Walang really? Ano ah, walang chika, mga ganun, early 40s.
Pwede, yeah, 50.
Yung kabata na nasabi sa akin. Pero actually, a lot of people have been surprised when they found out that I'm becoming a senior citizen and will get my discounts in about a month. So.
Talaga, anong secret? Bakit, you look so young for your age.
Well, you know, I guess healthy living, exercising. I can't say eating healthy food because I certainly didn't have the best diet when I was in Argentina. I was having steak every night.
Oh my God.
But I think it's also attitude, having the right frame of mind, being a better person, thinking kind things. Parang between being nasty and gossipy and being pleasant, for me, it's just much easier to be pleasant. So hopefully that's something that radiates to a lot of others. So,
kaya naman pala.
I mean, even in adversity, is the glass half full or is it half empty? I've always liked to think that it's always half full. That even in the worst possible situation, there's still some silver lining.
Totoo yan.
Akala ko, Leo, ano? Yeah, akala ko, aside from being optimistic and always being happy, thank you, Obaji. Kasi, Obaji gamit ko eh.
Yan, walang galaw, walang retoke yan. Ha? The only thing I put on is I need to put on moisturizer because I swim 3 kilometers a day. Well, for at least 4 times a week. So my skin will dry up too much from the chlorine. So I do need to put moisturizer. But that's about it. That's the only thing I do.
Oh, wow. O, talagang swimmer ka din.
Well, I mean, well, for health reasons. Kasi as a kid naman, I had the potential to have asthma. So as a preemptive thing, I started going into swimming to strengthen my lungs and whatever. So fortunately, I have all of the allergies of asthma. I just don't have asthma. So that's an upside.
Oh, wow. Aside from, parang ang feeling ko, ang ano mo, araw mo, or 1 week mo, sobrang busy. Like, one work after another, and parang ang dami-dami mong ginagawa.
Probably when I was younger, pero now, I try to take it easier. I try to, as I say, smell the roses.
Oh, kumbaga, parang, are you trying to like, you're harvesting now the fruit of your own labor when you were younger? Tapos ngayon, medyo...
I'm still working. I wish I could really rest. It's just that I think, I should really appreciate and enjoy life, even the little things. And I guess the pandemic also helped put a lot of that in perspective. Things that we would take for granted because we were so busy. Then all of a sudden, teka sandali pala, it's not that bad for you to slow down, to scale, to sit back and take stock of everything that's happening. So parang it's something that you it makes sense. Parang, for example, if you're going to go on a vacation, enjoy your vacation. If you're going to go with friends, have a nice time with friends. Rather, that's what I mean. Like, for example, when we have gatherings and whatever, as much as possible, my phone is either face down or in the bag. Because to me, one of the worst things is you go to a restaurant and you see so many people, they're together, they're not even speaking to each other because they're always looking at their cell phones. So to me, what's the point? Ba't pa kayo nag-get together? So parang halimbawa, pag nagkita tayo, I mean, short of you're expecting a call or whatever, I would have my phone down para you will have my undivided attention. And to me, that's just the way I think.
I know. Kahit ako, that's what I practice. Every time like I'm having, you know, like I'm in a party or having dinner, I always make sure that I put my phone. The only time I'll pick up my phone is, you know, selfie, take a picture of the food, and that's it. Yeah.
I don't even really use my phone for a selfie because I have a camera. I prefer the photos of a camera.
Oh, digital my. Or yung nostalgic na ano ba yon, yung film pa?
Ah, sobra ka naman. Wala na naman nagpo-process ng film dito.
I know. Parang, ano ba yung digital na?
Pero, ang maganda sa kanya kasi, you have an optical zoom. So with an optical zoom, you actually take clear pictures rather than a digital zoom where it becomes grainy.
Ah, so lagi, everywhere you go, you always have a small camera?
Yeah. Always.
Galing.
So like today, this afternoon, after this, we have an event called CCP Icons at St. Paul's College. So Vilma Santos is going to be there, Claudine is going to be there, national artist Ricky Lee is going to be there. So I'll have my camera handy. I'll be taking selfies because I always take selfies. So, and I've been taking selfies for like the last 20 years, even when it was still film. So people get surprised na, paano mo nagigitna yung photo? Eh, hindi mo naman nakikita. It's not like you're looking at a cell phone camera and then you can actually see how you're framed. Yung sa akin, nakaganon lang. And siguro ang batting average ko, 90%, nakagitna yan lagi. Minsan, bilihis ng konti. But practice makes perfect. And because before I used to go to a lot of the Hollywood studios when I was doing film acquisitions, parang if I'm going to be with Kerry Washington, I just have that window to shoot her. So parang good luck sa akin kung puro blurred yung kukunin ko. So, di ba, you kind of have to make sure that you're able to take good photos.
Oh,
with that
wow.
One shot that you have, with that one instance that you have.
Wait, saan nag-start yung ano mo, yung passion mo for film or photography? Nag-start ka ba sa photos or taking photos or videos?
My mom actually, when we were younger, we actually had a lot of photo albums. She was always the one who would take photos. Kaya wala siya usually sa photo. Pagkatapos, yung mga albums may handwritten anecdotes pa niya, the date, what was the event, and whatever. And probably because I did get to travel when I was early, because I was a foreign exchange student, I was able to go to Illinois. I studied in New Jersey East in Winnetka. Pagkatapos, my foster family stayed in Wilmette. And to me, sabi ko, I think that was really the start when I wanted to do photographs, because I wanted to capture that entire year in photographs. So whether it was my classmates, the other foreign exchange students, all the different places I would visit. Kasi we would go to Michigan, we go to Wisconsin. At the end of the school year, we had a bus tour of the continental United States, 20 states in 28 days. So I actually did see a lot of places that normally I wouldn't have seen. So I don't know if they're probably existing right now. But, you know, there was one time we went to an Indian reservation, then we went to this place in the Midwest na it was an entire building made out of corn cobs. Pagkatapos, I remember we were in the Grand Canyon and we slept in the Grand Canyon and they woke us up at 2 in the morning to do a 2.5-hour hike so that at exactly the time that sunrise would come, we would be on top and we would see the sunrise from the Grand Canyon. So I had a lot of those experiences. So I made sure that I would be able to keep a lot of those memories. And I still have the album. Although I have one album that's missing, kaya nafufrustrate ako. But I do have the album until now.
Yeah, pero siyempre, you're taking pictures, no? Yung mga pictures ba yun, even until now, do you have it printed? Tapos you put it in an album? Because a lot of people do that.
The pictures before were printed. But what I did, I had a master project where I would digitize everything. Pagkatapos, I would create metadata for everything. So like, di ba you take a lot of photos?
Yes.
Ako, when I take photos, I will put it in my computer and I will put the date, I will put the activity, the person's there and whatever. So in fact, for example, I took photos with you. Rather than trying to remember what date it was and whatever, I can just type Jesse in search or JCast
yes,
in search.
Yes, oh, metadata, all of your photos yes. Come
up. So you just have to think of a certain logic. That was about a 7-year project. So I would do that as I was scanning, I was putting the metadata and whatever. But the thing is, it puts all of your memories in a manageable folder. So the other day, I just finished cataloging the 1,500 photos I took in Argentina and Antarctica. So medyo sumasakit na yung ulo ko at mata ko. But you know, it's cataloged
to
the kind of detail that I want. So,
uy, ang galing!
Pero it's practical. Like for example, people will sometimes call me, uy, Leo, do you have our photos from like this? Because you want to do a photo tribute or whatever. Sabi ko, teka, sandali. What will probably take some people several weeks to do, I can do in about 15 minutes. Because you also have to wait for the computer to read everything. Hindi naman siya instantaneously magpapap eh.
Grabe.
Galing naman.
Ang sipag mo. Saan galing yung sipag?
I'm curious ha. Oh. I'm curious kasi ang dami mong pictures and you're cataloging when you're traveling the whole world. Do you have plans of like releasing this into a coffee table?
You know, when Charo came out with the book, some of the pictures in her book were actually from pictures that I took, some of her photos with celebrities and whatnot. Because I was working as her executive assistant for the longest time. So I always had my camera. So pag minsan may like si Fernando Carillo dadating, o kaya halimbawa kahit sina Angel Luxin dadating, I would always take a photo of that one. Photos, I don't know if anybody's actually going to be interested. Probably the most that people have been interested in is I have about siguro mga 200 celebrity selfies. And you're talking about foreign and local. So you're talking of Shonda Rhimes and Sally Field with Vilma Santos, Edwin D. Ruiz and Dali De Leon. But at the same time, I will also have sino pa ba? Daniel Day Kim, and I would have Terry Hatcher, I would have Jennifer Garner. So I would have all of those. So I do have all of those cataloged and whatever, because when I used to go to the LA screenings, to me, that was one of the perks. It was work, but I loved having selfies with the celebrities. And I remember there was one time I was with, I had met Katherine Heigl a few years earlier. Then I knew that she was going to be at a new party because she was promoting a new show. So I got the old photo. And when I approached her, I mean, it's a conversation starter. I said, you know, Katherine, we had the photo a long, long time ago. And I showed it to her. And I said, would it be fine for us to have another photo to update it? Tapos, sabi niya, of course. And she gave me the biggest smile and whatever. Ganda-ganda ng litrato namin eh. So may
mga... Ano pala, mga... Mabait pala si Katherine kasi iba yung nadidinig ko eh sa grapevine.
But I think it's also a gathering where they're talking to buyers and they're talking to
buyers.
Okay.
Whatever. Right. But you know, to be fair, you also catch them at a bad mood sometimes. I remember there was one time, I think Matthew Perry was there. I had seen Matthew Perry twice. Eh. One time he's very, very nice. But I think the other time that I saw him, he wasn't feeling well. So, minsan pag ganun naman, yung wag ka rin naman masyadong epal na parang
mag-iisip. Epal, yeah, true.
Itimplahin mo naman.
Picture, yung gumagano ng kape, no?
Oo, tipong kumakain na or is not feeling well.
You ask polite. Like, I remember I was in New York. Pagkatapos, I had watched the play with Glenn Close. So I approached her, I asked for a selfie, and she said, No, I don't do selfies. That was before nauso yung mga selfies. And I pretty sure she does it na now. Pagkatapos sabi ko, well, sabi ko, I've been a big fan and I've always liked your movies, but my favorite is, so I guess she was thinking, Dangerous Liaisons or some of her other more commercial. And I said, The House of the Spirits. Talaga, she stopped in her tracks because she was the best reviewed also in that movie. Pagkatapos, tumingin siya sa akin, tapos gumiti siya. And I figure it's probably one of the movies that she likes also.
Galing? Teka, na-curious ako. Yeah, na-curious ako. You've been around, you've been rubbing elbows to these big celebrities, but saan nag-start yan? I'm sure nung bata ka, did you ever think of like, you know, I want to be a writer, I want to be a director, I want to be a film producer? Saan I'm just curious to know, paano ka nag-umpisa?
I guess it all came out organically, at least for the love of movies. My mom and my dad like movies eh. So I would watch local movies with my mom, I would watch foreign movies with my dad, and I would remember, like, for example, Sundays, after lunch, we would watch a movie and whatever. Doon nga napanood yung Soylent Green. Kaya for 2 years, hindi ako kumakain ng gulay. Pagkatapos, so I really enjoyed the movies, and eventually, as I got older, it was never a problem for me to go on my own naman eh. So kung wala ako makakasama, manood ako mag-isa. So it's the same attitude I have with traveling. Pagkatapos, when it came to college, I purposely did not take film. Because my point is, it's something that I love. If I felt that it was going to be shoved down my throat by the teachers and I have to do thesis and reports and whatever, it would kill whatever love or interest I would have for it. So that pretty much turned out. I was originally taking up architecture, but since muntik na akong masaksak kasi ang late nung classes, I shifted. So eventually, para lang matapos na ako, I ended up taking philosophy. And then when I started working, I was working with Citibank. And then my sister at the time was the writer for Penthouse Live. It was, at that time, it was still Martin and Pops.
Okay.
So she was going to leave for the stage. She was going to get married. And then in the year prior to that, I had been her alalay. I had been her chaperone. And then I had been helping her. Like, for example, she would do the script and whatever. Minsan ako yung magta-type, ako yung mimeograph and whatever. So ang nangyari na lang after that, sabi ni Martin, sabi niya, why would we look for another writer when you said Leo has been helping anyway and we know that he can speak well and he can write well and he knows us and whatever. So why not Leo na lang? So basically, that's how my work as a writer started. Prior to that, I don't know if you know, remember Dong Puno, attorney Dong Puno.
Yes, we remember him.
So I was also a PA for that one when it was in Channel 7. Patricia Carver was the director at that time.
Wow.
Pagkatapos, my sister would... And like, for example, diba, when you're getting phone calls from your viewers, we had those big tape recorders, the open reel, and that's how we would record it. And then we would sift through it, and that's what would be played back. Everything is so simple now. It was also complicated before. So anyway, so I started out as a writer with Penthouse Live, but they also didn't have an editor. And at that time, ang production, mga limang tao lang kami. So I ended up being an editor also. So I studied on my own. So I became an editor and a writer. Then when we moved to ABS-CBN, that's when my break as a director for Tatak Pilipino and as an executive producer for Oh No, It's Johnny, the show Johnny Litton, that's when that came in. So at a certain point, I was directing Charo Spills in Maalaala Mo Kaya. I was editing OK Cafe Rico. I was directing Tatak Pilipino and editing it. I was co-writing and editing Ryan Musikahan and, you know, a lot of these other shows. That's where I got to work with Nora for the first time with Star Drama Presents Nora, the anthology program. Then I remember there was one time I was in the office of Freddy Garcia and I was already working with Penthouse Live. And I was, I always would take a peek when he would watch the foreign shows because that aside from what everything else that he does, he buys foreign programs from the States. So one time I was there, the stock room where we kept the tapes of Penthouse Live was there. So he had left a U-matic playing of a show from the US that was about to premiere in 8 months. So I was there, I was watching. He entered and then he asked me what I really wanted to do. And I said, your job. And you know, lo and behold, like for example, when Studio 23 was coming into fruition, Freddy Garcia talked to Charo because at that time I was with Charo and I'd already set up the ABS-CBN film archives. I was already with film acquisitions. Then Freddy Garcia said that, you know, I want to take Leo to be the head of acquisitions and programming for Studio 23. So that's how that evolved naman. And then eventually I became manager of of Studio 23. So Charo reluctantly gave me up. Sabi niya, Leo, I'm not gonna stop. I'm not going to stand in the way of such a great promotion. And this is really what you wanted to do. So I was executive assistant when she was head of production. And then when Charo became president naman of ABS-CBN, she also called me and asked if I could go back and be her executive assistant, chief of staff again. So yun, so I ended up, so yung intervening years on was the Studio 23 years. And then I set up the Film Archives in 1994. And then we started talks of film restoration in 2009. Prior to that, we had considered it, but it was a very, very expensive and difficult proposition because everything was analog. So, kumbaga, there were certain things you could fix, but given the condition of our materials, there were other things you could not. Then in about 2009, I had met Manette Dayrit a few years ago. And then at that time, their company was pitching film restoration done digitally. So they had shown it to me. Then we looked at it. They were testing it with Maalaala Mo Kaya. And then after that, once, parang ako kasi purist ako, ang feeling ko mas gusto ko pa rin film. But I saw the merits of it, and I saw that they could fix certain things that could not be fixed on a manual or an analog level. So when that happened, we made a presentation to management. Char was president at that time, and Gabby was the chairman. And Gabby has always had a love for cinema also. So I think we never really had a problem because Gabby and Charo were both advocates of that plan. And then Gabby was saying that, you know, Leo, I know this is something that we have to do. We have to prepare the materials of ABS-CBN when the new technologies arrive. Wala pa mga streaming nito eh. You just want usapan pa lang HD para luminaw yung copy for television. And I guess for cable and for satellite. I think satellite was starting to begin then. So, sabi, ang sinabi ko lang kay Gabby, sabi ko, Gabby, the only thing I can promise you is I will be very, very careful and I will be very judicious in how I spend the monies of ABS-CBN to make sure that we are able to do our vision and, ano, handle the finances responsibly. So basically, that's how that started. So, Film Restoration officially started 2011. We released Himala in 2012. And in fact, Himala was supposed to be released in August. But I think around June, I got a call or a message from the Venice Film Festival. And they said that, you know, Himala premiered here so many years ago. And we heard that you had restored it. Is it possible to have the premiere in Venice? And I said, premiere in Manila, premiere in Venice. Ano ba pipiliin ko dyan sa dalawang yan?
Sure, so we pushed
Manila to December. And then the restored Himala premiered in Venice. I think at that time, she was also in Venice. I'm not sure if she was promoting a movie that Brillante Mendoza made. I'm not sure. But basically, since Nora was there and nobody could come, Nora though was the one who introduced Himala in Venice. Eh. So that was a very, very nice turnout.
Grabe, wow. Alam mo, while listening to you, parang nagpa-fast. No. Ano, parang you have an amazing glorified life. It's like, ang saya, parang, was there a point na parang meron ka namang down? Kasi parang I feel like lahat ng mga gusto mo, like, gusto mong ma-achieve in life, like you
it was a actually, ball rolling uphill,
yeah,
basically.
It's like rolling in your palm, just like that.
No, it's a lot of hard work. It just sounds like that everything was happening and occurring at a very good pace. No, but it's a lot of hard work. There were a lot of failures along the way and whatever. But as I said, generally, ang titingnan ko ba yung masamang nangyari o yung maganda?
Tama. Yes,
so,
tama.
Even with the setting up Studio 23 and even with setting up the archives, for a lot of this, siguro 90% is hard work, 10% sure. Is the uplifting part, but I choose to look at the uplifting part. Kasi ang point ko naman, why will I dwell naman on the hard work? But, you know, I look at the end product. Parang ano, when you talk about film restoration is a very difficult job. It's not something that a lot of people agree with also, because sometimes they would say, why don't you spend na lang the money on a newer film or whatever? And I do have a retort for that. But to me, when somebody approaches you, like a young person approaches you and said that, you know, salamat ho at ni-restore niyo itong pelikulang ito kasi ho, kayo lang namin siya napanood, ngayon lang namin na-realize na maganda pala siya. Or like for example, I remember there was one time I was talking to Rafa Sigyon Reyna and we had restored a movie that his dad had done and he said, you know, I never saw this movie. Magaling pala talaga ang tatay ko. And you know, we've had that kind of conversation from descendants. Like, for example, we did Giliw Ko, which is from 1939, and that's the oldest that we've done. So we had, when we were doing that, I talked to the head of the Metropolitan Theater because it had premiered in the Metropolitan Theater in 1939, pre-war. It's only one of five surviving pre-World War II movies. So when I talked to him, I said, wouldn't it be nice that the restored Giliw Ko will premiere in the restored Metropolitan Theater 84 years after or 83 years after? And sabi, I think, like the idea, so even as a marketing or a communications handle, parang Giliw Ko comes back home to the Met. And I mean, none of the stars are, I mean, they're all dead. But like, for example, Lilia Dison, I'm blanking out. But the lead actress of Giliw Ko is the great-great-grandmother of Congressman Gaston Bunting. So you have a generational thing. So the Tambuntings were there. They attended the premiere, and you know they would approach us and they would thank us. Thank you for allowing the work of our grandmother to survive, so that so that her grandkids and the next generation will be able to see it. It's no different when we were premiering Captain Barbell, and there was a 20-year-old who approached me and said that, pwede po bang magpanood ang Captain Barbell? And that was an invitational screening. Tapos sabi ko, Captain Barbell, sigurado ka? Kasi katabi ni Captain Barbell was a theatrical run of Captain Marvel. Sabi ko, hindi ba Captain Marvel ang ibig mo sabihin? Sabi, hindi po Captain Marvel yung kay Dolphy. Tapos sabi ko, bakit? Bakit mo kilala? Ang bata-bata mo pa. Medyo matagal na rin patay si Dolphy.
Yes.
Tapos sabi niya, Dolphy is the favorite actor of my dad. And my dad would always take us to watch all of the Dolphy movies whenever we could catch it. So my dad is here, my mom is here, I think a younger sibling was there. So yung sa akin, it was such a heartwarming feeling. Mm-hmm. But those are the kinds of things kasi that you will end up living for. Eh. Kasi wala ka na makukuha masyado financially and whatever. Parang di ba? Parang you know that in reality, you are in the lowest rung of the totem pole sa mga papanuuri ng tao. Kasi they will watch something na boy pa yung artista, bata pa yung artista.
Rather exactly. than
Yung yes. sikat at trending, di ba?
Trending, ganun. Oo. Pero mahal
so,
bang ano?
So with something like that, it just makes it much more fulfilling. It parang you suddenly have the feeling inside that, you know, all the hard work was worth it. Because it is a lot of hard work. From deciding what movie to restore to the restoration process, to the enhancement process, to thinking up of new posters and how you will market it and how you promote it. Kasi, klaro rin naman sa amin, we have to do this as an advocacy. We have to promote it. Because as a young kid, why will you watch or why will you ask for something that you are totally unaware of? So, our responsibility is to make people aware of it. Ang feeling ko kasi, pag halimbawa namatay dun sa generation namin na nakaka-appreciate pa dun sa mga luma, wala na. Sino na magtutuloy nun? So, you're hoping that you would cultivate the love and the interest and the passion in the next generation.
Ang galing, but how do you usually pick which movie to showcase? Kasi ang dami.
Well, when we were starting, we wanted to be writer and director centric. Kasi madali ang star centric. Ang dami ng ginagawa. But initially, we wanted to do a cross section. So while we did have a lot of movies with us, we had to prioritize. So I wanted, say, a Mike De Leon. I wanted a Lino Broca. I wanted a Celso Ad Castillo. I wanted an Eddie Romero. So before I would drill down to the works of a particular director, I tried to have a wider cross-section first. Like maybe 12 directors na magkakaiba. Then, at a certain point, it also depends on kung anong material na yung available sa'yo. What is readily accessible. So when you have your list of writers and directors like Ricky Lee, Raquel Villavicencio, Miguel Ortesa, so on and so forth. When you have that list, you also have the titles that are there. And obviously, meron kang wish list. Like for example, for Celso Ad Castillo, I always say that would Virgin People be my top preference of his movies to restore? No. But it was the one that was immediately available to us. Eh. So, I would have preferred Burlesque Queen. But tinan mo, until now, ang Burlesque Queen, wala pa rin. Pag puti ng uwak, pag itim ng tagak, until now, wala pa rin. So, you also have to be flexible in that regard. So, you try
what,
to look at...
What do you mean na hindi sila available, Leo? Hindi pa ayaw pa nila ipa-restore? Ganun ba yung mga
example? It's the availability of the physical materials because we can only restore from a print or from a negative. So una-una titingnan mo, hahanapin mo, meron ba? Kumpleto ba yan? Buo pa ba siya? ano yung condition niya. Like for example, when we found Moral, ito kasi Moral, ano to, this was a second set of prints that surfaced eh. Nung una naming nakita yung Moral, nung binuksan yung mga lata, three or four of the five or six scans were already melted. So hindi yan dadaan ng scanner eh. So minsan yun yung nakakalungkot. I remember Vilma, when I talked to Vilma before for Pagputi ng Uwak, she was very very happy because she produced that movie eh. Sabi niya that movie is a labor of love. Eh nung nakakita kami ng kopya ng Pagputi ng Uwak, lusaw na siya. And more often than not in the Philippines, isang kopya lang yung nagsusurvive. So medyo mahirap talaga. So titingnan mo rin yun. Pagkatapos titingnan mo sino bang may-ari, ilan bang may-ari, marami bang may-ari, kakausapin mo rin lahat yun. Pagkatapos, then you will go through the process of actually scanning the movie. Then when you scan, parang think of it this way. The reason you're scanning a print or a negative is you want to have a digital file which would have a lot of information. So that when you would do your digital restoration, your manual restoration, you are able to work with more. So think of it this way, na parang halimbawa, kumuha kayo ng litrato. Yung litrato mo, 10 MB, pero yung kinopya ng, yung kinuha ng isang kasama mo, 100 KB. Kahit i-zoom in mo ng i-zoom in yung 10 MB, malinaw pa siya kasi maraming detalye. Pero yung 100 KB, nag-pipixelize na siya. So that's also the difference. So you would have to look for, that's why we would always prefer rin a master negative, assuming that it survives. Kasi yun ang pinakamaraming information. So I don't know if you remember, or maybe at least in New York, they probably still have film. Like, paribawa, pag nagpaparecopy ka ng negative, di ba ang lutong-lutong ng video, ng photo? Pero pag ang pinarecopy mo is a print, di ba ano na siya, soft na siya? Kasi there's not that much information in the print. You're limited to the information in the print. In the negative, all the grains are there. If you wanted to manipulate it and whatever, magagawa mo doon.
Grabe, pero curious ako ha. So how do you... where do you usually showcase it? Set on TV, Sky Cable, or talagang merong sa cinema?
One of the things that I decided on is, ano kasi mindset yan eh. Di ba pag halimbawa, parang ganito, let me backtrack a bit. When we were doing the restoration, ang priority kasi dyan was Star Cinema or the films owned by ABS-CBN. But at the time we started, Star Cinema wasn't even 20 years old eh. So sabi ko, paano mo i-handle ang marketing yan? Paano ipopromote sa tao? Parang, oh okay, it's an 18-year-old movie, so what's interesting about it? Pero kung halimbawa, so I asked Mr. Lopez, sabi ko, Gabi, pwede ba akong kumuha ng mas mga lumang pelikula na totoong classics? Kasi yun yung magiging cornerstone ng buong kampanya. Pagkatapos, we can position Star Cinema because they did have very, very good movies even early on. Eh. So, ipoposition mo yun at sasabihin mo that potential, modern classics, and whatever, patatandain mo lang naman yan eh. Parang in the same way that Tanging Yaman is more or less a classic na now and sana maulit is a classic right now. Pero at 18 years, hindi pa siya ano. Pero at 30 years, oo na. Di ba? So you have to give it that mindset. Pagkatapos sabi ko, kung hindi mo ibabalik sa sinihan at ipapakita mo lang sa TV, so what's special about it? All the movies end up in TV. Sure. But putting it in a cinema with a red carpet premiere, with celebrities attending, well hopefully celebrities would attend kasi marami rin patay na. It would give it a very, I guess more of a cachet, more of a heft or gravitas na parang, uy, teka, importante, pinagkakagastusan nila eh. Gumawa ng bagong poster, gumawa ng bagong trailer, may red carpet premiere pa, hindi mura yon. So, may mindset kang ganun. So, nung ganun, pagkatapos, we were inviting celebrities, and you know, fortunately, a lot of the celebrities did like the older movies. So, they would go, even if they were not part of the movie, and you know, they would lend their voice and whatever. They would post on their socials and whatever. And it would certainly help our awareness. Which is actually why we ended up winning the International Gold Quill a few years later. In a campaign that was led by Piolo Pascual. Kasi ang sabi ko, kung ako lang naman na magsasalita, ba't naman ako papakinggan ng mga tao? Sino rin ba naman ako? Pero if it were sina Ricky Lee and sina Nora Honor and sina Piolo Pascual, sina Angel Aquino, sina Maha Salvador, sina Ricky Davao, sina Jimmy Fox, when you have all of these important people starting to talk about the movies, people will take notice. So we had a campaign, and in fact, that was why we won the International Gold Quill. Kasi nagulat sila na ganun yung naging kampanya namin. Pagkatapos, ang sabi ko nga, I always have to thank Piolo for it. Because the moment Piolo said yes, umauna yung maraming artista eh. I remember I was in France at that time. They were there for a Heartthrobs tour, I think. Pagkatapos, I met up with Piolo in Nice. Pagkatapos, sabi ko, PJ, I have this pitch for you. I hope you would consider it. I think I was 2 minutes into my pitch. Sabi ni Piolo sa akin, Leo, I believe in what you're doing. Just tell me when I have to be there and what I have to do and I'll be there. And he's been there. And oh, all of my, through the years, he's been there. So all waves of our campaign has been there. So those are the kinds of things that will give it importance. And then I'm sure you've heard of the name Sagip Pelikula.
Sagip Pelikula, yes.
It was officially coined in 2015. Kasi prior to that, it was ABS-CBN Film Restoration. It's a mouthful. But you also wanted something that's catchy. So Ian Faustino, the person who does our trailers, thought of that. Sabi niya, sir, di ba ang ABS may Sagip Pelikula, Sagip Kapamilya? Bakit tayo hindi Sagip Pelikula? Sabi ko, ang ganda niyan, Ian. So that's the name that we've started using. And that's caught on. So we've had the same poster maker from the beginning, si Justin Bisana. And now, he's one of the most in-demand poster makers everywhere. And his posters that he's done for us is really very, very nice. Some people have started their careers with us and whatever. So nakakatuwa. Lagi ko kasi sinasabi, pag nag-update kayo ng resume, lagi niyong ilagay yung ABS-CBN Sagip Pelikula at saka ABS-CBN Film Restoration. Kasi ang ganda-ganda ng goodwill niya sa napakaraming tao.
Grabe, nakailang ano na kayo, Film Restoration? How many?
I think right now we're about 210 or 212. Actually, dapat nasa mga 250 na kami. But I'm sure you know that what happened with ABS in 2020. And we went from 20 to 30 movies to about 2 movies a year. If even that.
Oh, wow.
So we don't elaborate anymore why what happened there. But
ay, alam na natin.
Exactly. Alam na ng aware na lahat dyan. Pero ano pa ba? I mean, are you still doing this until now?
We're still doing the restoration when we can get budget. And yeah. We're, at saka right now kasi, I had to pivot. So, kasi normally, everything is outsourced kasi wala naman kami capability for the pristine restorations. But we were able to get a film scanner and we would scan the films kasi you have to bring down the costs. So, we would bring down the cost of the movies by doing some of the work in-house. So we had the film scanner and we would do that and then we would send out the digital files and that's what they would work on for color grading, color corrections, for the manual restoration frame by frame, for both audio and video. So they would work on that. Nung nagsara ang ABS-CBN and naapektuhan kami, one of the things that we decided on was, teka sandali, we also still had the LVN catalog. If my mandate is I cannot spend, I cannot go outside and whatever, anong kaya natin gawin in-house? So, we started working more on the LVN titles. Technically naman, hindi mo na siya rin mapipristine because of their condition. So, what we did were brand new scans and enhancements. And, you know, we've been able to do about 10 movies already in the past 4 years. Or past 5 years. 2020 pala nagsimula. So yun, nandyan yung Giliw Ko, nandyan yung Mutya ng Pasig, nandyan yung Triplets, Sandata at Pangako, Anak Dalita, Badyaw, Biyaya ng Lupa. And to me, Biyaya ng Lupa is one of the best Filipino films ever made. To me, that's our Citizen Kane.
Anong favorite mo sa lahat ng na-restore mo?
Nako, parang sa sinabi mo na mamimili siya ng favorite na anak niya.
Anak niya?
Actually, mahirap yung tanong na yan because my favorites change depending on my mood. So, for example, there would be times like, obviously, it would be in Biyaya, Himala, and whatever. But for, when you say kasi favorite, yung sa akin, I don't do this, I do more of this. So it depends on my mood. Like, there will be times it will be the films of Olive Lamasan, like Sana Maulit Muli, or Minsan Minahal Kita. Or there will be times it will be something older. For the Marilu Diaz-Abayas, my favorite has always been Karnal. For the Mike De Leons, it's been Kung Mangarap Kat Magising and Kakabakaba. I mean, people will say that Kisap Mata and Sister Stella L and some of the other movies are better. I will not dispute that because it's a subjective thing. But I will always boil down to, at the end of the day, pag pinapalabas ba yun, alin ba yung uulit-ulitin mo? Kasi people can ridicule Pretty Woman and they can ridicule Ghost, but it's comfort food eh. Parang every time it will play or A Miracle on 34th Street or The Sound of Music, they may not be the most iconic, but I will watch Sound of Music more than Lawrence of Arabia. But arguably one may be better crafted than the other. But that's why yung ano, when we were doing best 10 bets, that was also one of my concerns eh. Kasi originally ang plano naman diyan, nag-aaway kami sa ranking. Eh hindi ako naniniwala doon kasi ang akin it's a subjective call. I do not believe that there is a single person who's the arbiter of what is good. So, you respect the opinions, not unless it's horridly bad. But I think generally, you will rank it depending also on perception. Like there would be tapos sabi ko, if what you wanted was an absolute authority, hindi akong kukunin mo. Kasi hindi ko naman i-claim na absolute authority ako ng film eh. I mean, there's also a lot of movies that I haven't watched. I have watched a lot of the movies from the 70s, 80s, and the 90s. But maybe with the last 10 years, it wouldn't have been as much anymore. Because I really don't have the time also. So yung sa akin, like yung ano, that was one of the tweaks that we did when we were talking about best 10 bets. Na parang, no, let's have our own rankings, let's defend our rankings, let's defend our choices. But I'm not going to say na, bakit si ganyan yung number 2 mo? Eh, kung yun ang pakiramdam mo eh. Kung yun ang taste mo eh, kung yun ang preference mo eh. It's like a question of Anuranian and a Vilmanian. Diba? Pwede kayong mag-away hanggang magunawang mundo, hindi kayo magkakasundo eh. So to me, what's the point? But if you were to offer a diversity of opinion, then hopefully, you're also giving insight to your viewers who will form their own lists.
Oh, sure. Yung sa kanya-kanyang ano yan.
The threads of best and bets. Hindi ko nga masyado binabasa eh. I mean, I will try to read it. But there are some people who are really just there, who are insulting. They'll call me stupid. They'll call me, ano ba naman yung mga choice mo? Parang wala kang alam. Parang yung sa akin, it's a preference eh. So, that's why, much as, kasi yung sa Studio 23 and sa Sagip Pelikula, ako yung sumasagot sa mga message boards and threads eh. But it's also a more civilized discourse. Rather than you'll read the discourse, there'll be a few that will give comments na magaganda and whatever. But the rest, they just bash you, they just criticize you and whatever. So sabi ko, it's not naman good for my sanity to read that. Napaka upbeat at positive kong person pagkatapos ang pagbababasahin ko yung mga tao na pagawa kong dipumunega.
Oo, papatulan mo yung mga keyboard warriors. O Leo nga pala. Na-mention mo na, ikaw na nagsabi ng bagong show mo, Best 10 Bets. Akala ko yes. Best 10 Bex. Kasi kung Best 10 Bex yan, kasama ako doon ha, sa listahan. Kahit number 10. Pero okay, so tell us all about it. How did it come into fruition? How did you birth this show all of a sudden?
No, I wasn't part of the original conceptualization. But I remember, over the past years, I've always been talking to Mark Yambot. And he's always wanted to do something with me. And he's always been telling me that, Leo, you should be on camera and whatever. Ako naman, I never saw myself as that. I never thought of myself as being on camera. Even before when, I remember when I was starting the business, Mother Lily told me na, "Oy, ayaw mo mag-artista, pwede kang kapatid ni Ricky Dabao." Ricky was already, sabi niya,
"Oh nga pala, you look like him."
Pwede.
Sabi ko, na mother, hindi na. Kasi at that time, I was editing Rumors, Facts, and Humor for Regal. But anyway, so, yung ito naman, then one day, Mark Yambot called me and he said he and Butch Francisco had been brainstorming about a show na ito yung concept and whatever. Eh yung sa akin naman, while I don't think of myself as an on-camera person, I'm not going to say no outright without trying it. Eh yung sa akin naman, di ba? If you like me, well and good. If I like it, well and good. If it doesn't work out, at least I tried it. So I cannot say that, I decided in a vacuum. So, he told me that, but originally nga, the concept was, yung magde-defend kami, mag-aaway kami on the choices. Pero sabi ko, I don't think that really will work eh, kasi hindi ko personality yun eh. Yung sa akin, I will respect your choice. I will not insist on whatever because I will not pretend to know more than you. In the same way that I will also acknowledge that sometimes my exposure to certain areas or certain categories would be more limited. Like for example, obviously, I will end up being more familiar with the ABS-CBN stars. I've watched a handful of GMA shows, but I will not be as well-versed or as in-depth in them. And for me, it's also, I will never comment on something that I do not know. Kasi yung sa akin, J-Cas, for example, may disagree with me. Pero if he disagrees with me, it's still something that I know about. So alam kong opinion ko. Hindi yung hearsay na sinabi na, tapos yun yung biglang i-defend ko. Kasi pag ganun, you're treading very, very thin ice eh. Paano mo i-defend ang hindi ka naman familiar? So, in fact, even when we discuss topics, there's topics that I would say that I'm not comfortable with that since I really don't know anything about that. And, even if I do research, research is very, very different from a very first-hand interaction. And yung sa akin, I think a lot of the insight that we bring to the show is the fact that we know a lot of the backstories. Eh. There are personal relationships at play. You have met these people. You have talked to them, not necessarily in confidence, but in conversations where most people will not be privy to. So when you have that kind of dynamic, then you start talking about it, then you do have the insight that you can share with people. Especially since a Pilipino, hindi naman mahilig mag-document. So anyway, so going back, so when Mark called me, sabi ko, you know, I don't think I'm the best person for it, but yeah, I'll give it a shot. So after that, nag-meeting kami with sina Butch and the team. Pagkatapos pinag-usapan nun, tapos medyo fina-fine-tune yun. Then after a while, we identified at least the first few episodes that we would do. Then we had our first taping na. And then, you know, like for example, people have been asking na, nag-away ba kayo ni Butch? Sabi ko, hindi. Pero ganun naman kami talaga mag-usap eh. Maybe it just gets magnified because it's a short show and you're talking about certain things. But when we're arguing off camera, eh, ganun rin naman kami mag-ano eh. And the thing is naman, hindi naman ako pikon, hindi naman siya pikon. Now, maybe sometimes there's a bit more posturing because it's television. But for the most part, that's it. That's really the way would ano kung nagsusupalpalan kami and whatever. Pero ano siya, it's all ano good natured. I'm sure Jesse, kayo ni J-Cas pag nagbibiruan kayo. Minsan naman may pagkabaru, pwede rin may pagkabarubal siya eh. But it doesn't mean nag-aaway.
So exactly. Oo. We just know each other so much.
Uh-oh. We're just passionate.
Yeah.
Yes.
Especially Butch. Because I think, well, I wouldn't say that Butch has a photographic memory, but I think he remembers more when he hears it rather than when he reads it. And in that regard, it's photographic because the amount of detail and information that he has is really just amazing. And that's something that I keep saying. I used to have a photographic memory when I was a kid, but when the dentist did me 3 root canals na puro anesthesia dito,
Nawala. My brain cells medyo, anesthesia.
Malapit sa utak. Eh, ang mali, kaya yung mga more recent dentist ko, nabigla sila nung nalaman nila, but I was still young eh, na ganun yung ginawa, kasi dapat daw hindi ginagawa yun. Kasi isipin mo dati, sa exam, bisan ko lang babasahin, memoryado ko na siya. As in, literally, nakikita ko yung page. Kaya kahit mga declamation contest, mga elocution contest, madali ako sumali. Kasi kahit magbasa ng encyclopedia, kaya ko. Kasi isang basa ko lang, matatandaan ko na siya. That was gone after the anesthesia. Kaya parang, I don't know if you're married, but pero kung halimbawa, di ba sinasabi na pag yung dating magaling ang memory pagkatapos nakakalimutan, they're having an epidural moment. Kasi di ba, yun yung anesthesia.
Yeah, yung epidural, yes. Ano ba yan? Epidural
kasi.
Yun. Yung akin dito.
Diretso sa utak, hindi na ata ginagawa ngayon yun.
So that's why nalungkot ako. That's why ako I cannot sing. Because I cannot remember lyrics verbatim. Lagi kong may papalitan ako dyan.
Pero ito, curious ako.
Pero I remember so details. I will just not remember it word for word.
Ako din.
Kaya magaling ako magbasa ng kontrata eh. Kasi natatandaan ko siya. Natatandaan ko yung detalye. Hindi ko masasabi sa yung exact wording, but I will know exactly what it's saying. And I can
yung content mismo. Oh, got it. Like, curious ako, who decided na si Butch Francisco and Leo Katigbak has to be the host of Best of 10 Best?
Well, Butch was already the host when he and Mark were talking. But according to Mark, Butch was the one who suggested my name.
Oh. Pero ang kaninong brainchild talaga ang show na.
Well, I guess Mark Yambot and Butch Francisco. Kasi I came in naman, medyo buo na yung concept eh. Nagpasok lang ako ng opinion ko, ng idea ko.
Wow. So, kasi parang, all this time, you're always like behind the scene. Eh. Tapos ngayon, biglang, in front of the camera.
I told them, sabi ko, you know, tell me how it works. If the advertisers don't like me, that's fine, that's well and good and whatever. Yung sa akin lang, I tried it. Parang I cannot say. Parang kumbaga generally naman, I will try it so that I will have an informed decision whether I like it or not. Parang nung nasa Antarctica ako, polar plunge, yung parang ano, ice bucket challenge. Pero tatalong ka sa Antarctica, so mas malamig yun. So people were telling me, ba't mo ginawa? Eh yun sa akin, paano ko sasabihin na malamig at saka ganito yung feeling kung hindi ko actually gagawin? O hindi ginawa ko, I can categorically say that this is how it feels and whatever because I had the first-hand experience.
So Leo, ang tanong ko, malamig ba?
Alam mo, magnanumb ka.
Oh, wow.
How many minutes did you stay actually?
No, several seconds lang. Kasi,
ganun.
Hindi, tsaka kasi ako, while I swim, I have an aversion for oceans kasi hindi ko nakikita ilalim. And then at that time that we were swimming, there were whales circling the boat, the ship. So, sabi siguro ng mga whales, anong pinagagawa ng mga tao to? Talon sila ng talon. So, at saka kasi hindi katulad yung nagpunta ka ng mga Hawaii or whatever, na it's crystal blue. Dito, the water is dark eh. So, hindi mo alam kung ang ilalim niya talaga. So, wala akong nakikita sa ilalim. Pag ganun ay panic eh. So, yung sa akin, to the extent na nakatalon ako, nakalangoy ako, siguro in the water maybe 10-15 seconds. Hindi katulad ng iba na lumangoy pa. Pero kasi may tali ka naman eh. Para kung matatakot ka, they can always pull you in. Pero yung iba, lumangoy pa and whatever. So they probably stayed mga 45 seconds, 30-45 seconds. Ako mga 10 to 15 lang.
Oof. I'm trying to imagine. Oh my God, parang...
Kung ako yan, yes. If I'm there already, I would have done the same. I will do this. When am I going to come back? I'm not going to do this
next time.
You don't have to do it again. But at least you did it once. Pagkatapos, pag akyat mo, bibigyan ka lang ng Grey Goose vodka. So, kahit doon.
Oh.
Kasi kailangan para uminit yung katawa. Ang sarap-sarap rin naman. Uh-oh.
Oh my God. Parang,
gusto ko yun yung prize.
I'm sure gagawin talaga yun ni J-Cast. For sure. Ako, no, I'm not. Napaka-adventurous. Lumipad na lang kayo.
How difficult is it to fly from New York to South America, to Buenos Aires? Some flight line?
Yeah, it's easier here talaga. Yeah, pero...
Exactly.
But, ano in the future na yan? Kasi nga, malamig eh.
Alam mo, parang it reminds me of ano?
Well, the time to do it is actually October to March because summer. So,
hindi masyado.
Kasi when we were in Antarctica, it's mga... Pinapawisan nga ako dun. Kasi it's ano eh, it's... Ang malamig, -2 during the day. Eh, the sun is out for like 20 hours a day. Pagkatapos, ang warm nila is about 1 or 2 degrees. You're in Antarctica, tapos 1 to 2 degrees. Tapos nakalabas yung
like,
araw.
This is a cruise, right? A cruise.
Yes. Hindi ka naman pwedeng separate flight. Eh. Wala naman. Ang lumilipad lang ata doon are the research stations.
Wow, parang gusto ko tuloy po. Pero, no, hindi ako ganun ka-adventurous para gawin yun. I'll take pictures. Parang mga ganun doon.
No, but it really depends on what you like. Eh. Kasi if I wasn't working and if I had the resources, I'd be traveling. I've always liked to travel. I wish I started traveling earlier. But ganun talaga. Eh. Kasi,
kasama mo family mo?
Hindi, usually solo ko. Or with friends. Pero yung sa akin kasi, whether nanonood ako na sine or ano, ang sa akin, magsasabi ako, gusto nyo ba sumama? Pero yung ang plano ko mag-hinge on somebody else's plan, I will never do it. Katulad itong Antarctica, there were some people who said yes. Ultimately, everybody backed out. Eh.
Oh.
Ako lang na tuloy. Eh, ang point ko kasi, pag nag-decide ako, tuloy na yan. Kahit mag-isa ako, itutuloy ko yan. Kasi wala ako mapupuntahan kung mag-aantay lang ako lagi. And then, some people are so indecisive.
Exactly.
Some people will say that they want to, but they will give a lot of reasons why they will not or they cannot. Ay, nagkami ano last minute things to work and whatever. You can plan all of those eh. So yung sa akin, I had been looking at doing it for over a year. Pagkatapos, September pa lang nakabook na ako eh, for January. By October, I already had my tickets. So even before I started Best 10 Bets, nakaplano na yan. So sabi ko, wala ako on these dates. So kung gusto yung mag-taping, wala ako dito.
Galing! Napaka-adventurous. Oo, totoo yan. But do you have kids?
No. I'm not married.
Okay. So kasi kung may kids ka, I'm sure kasama mo mga kids mo, no? Kasama mo sila.
Well, that's also the other thing. Eh. The not having kids allows me the flexibility to travel. And you were saying that, di ba, I look 40 and whatever. One of my greatest frustrations is when I travel, I really like talking to younger people. Eh. Kaya lang kung matanda ako, eh hindi mo mukha naman akong cradle snatcher kung ganun. So at least, because I guess I look young, I still blend with a lot of younger people. And they don't get intimidated talking to me. I probably will not have the same interests as them. Kasi magwawalwal lang naman sila, tsaka iinom. Eh hindi naman ako mahilig uminom. Pero kung halimbawa traveling and whatever. So I end up making friends with people who are, I guess, like-minded. So like, I've actually stayed in touch with some people that I have met over the years. I visited them in their homes. We still send Christmas cards and postcards to each other. Like, I remember there's this family from Finland that I met when I was in Greece. And at that time, the girl was probably in her teens. Eh, ngayon, nakapang-military school na siya, nagtatrabaho na. We've stayed friends. And siya yung nakipagkwentuhan sa akin. This is about maybe 12, 14 years ago. So siya yung nakipagkwentuhan, and I look in my 30s, so hindi, lalong hindi naman ako mukhang cradle snatcher ko. So we ended up talking, yung family niya and whatever. So in fact, even the family is very, very nice to me and whatever. And we've stayed friends until now. Another was, I think I was, where was I? I think I was taking a train, go somewhere in Europe. Pagkatapos, ang nakasabay ko naman was former high school principal. And now we're still in communication. And she was older than me. She was retired na. But I visited her in her home. Kapit-bahay niya, anak ni Meryl Streep. Napagkwentuhan na namin yun. So,
grabe. Parang nakakatuwa, no? Kasi you're not scared to travel alone and meet people. Kasi yung iba, ako, I don't know. I haven't tried it and I'm scared to do it. Rico, talaga,
I'm even scared to go on the bar by myself. Let alone travel on my own.
Ako naman hindi naman ako nagbabarman. Kasi naman hindi naman ako iinom rin talaga. But di ba I said earlier that I studied in Illinois when I was a Rotary Youth Exchange student. So at 15 years old, I was away from my family. I had the foster family in Wilmette.
Oh.
But I got my first taste of independence then. And you know, while you would still do things with a lot of your kids and whatever, doon rin na, dito naman kasi hindi ka naman naglalakad papuntang school eh. Eh ako, naranasan ko, naiwan ako ng school bus at naglakad ako ng 45 minutes with 1 foot snow from Winnetka hanggang bahay. So, pag may mga ganun ka ng mga experiences, generally, hindi ka na matatakot. You just have to be smart about it.
Yeah. Is there one thing na, you know, you're scared about? Kasi parang feeling ko, you're so adventurous na you don't care. Like, you know what? Life is YOLO. Diba? You only live once. Let's do this.
Yeah, hindi, meron naman. Kasi syempre, you really have to be careful. Because if something does happen, and because you're traveling alone, pwede wala kang matatakbuhan. So yun. Tapos, syempre, it's not as if I'm a spring chicken. So, with my age, then you're hearing people your age dying of heart attack and all of these conditions and whatever. It also crosses your mind that you're likely a candidate for something like that because of your age. So, nakakatakot rin yun. Eh, but if it happens abroad and whatever, di ba? Hindi naman ganun kadali. Oh, pagkatapos sa na nilang mawawala, face of the earth, pagkatapos natataranta yung pamilya mo dito. So,
oo nga, na-apekto.
Exactly, oo.
Napuntahan mo na halos lahat. Anong next mo? Saan ang next adventure mo na nakikita mo? Saan mo gusto mo?
Yeah, nasa bucket list mo pa.
Actually, ang dami pa. You know, I've not been to Africa. So, that's I've always wanted to go to Egypt. I've always wanted to go to Morocco also. So, we'll see if that's something I can do. But, like this year, the two places I want to go to are Japan. I really like Japan. It was for a time lang, Japan became so expensive. And then New York. Because I really love New York.
Oo nga, syempre, there's nothing.
Kahit ano, kahit, kasi ang New York kasi ano eh, I know what you're talking about, the energy. Once you feel it, once it grabs onto you, you'll always after it. Kasi yung iba, it is glamorous, but it's also dirty. It's dirty at the same time.
Yeah,
you have to accept both facets, di ba? Eh, sabi ko, I don't know. I still love it. I'm not done with New York yet.
Yeah.
Pero kasi parang ng feeling na whether nakatira ka sa condo or sa hotel, pagbaba mo, paglabas mo ng kalye, the energy is there. Eh. Well, you even when you're in Queens, there are a lot of people going around and whatever. In fact, ang feeling ko nga, New Yorkers get a bum rap na sinasabi na masungit sila and whatever. I actually like New Yorkers better than people from LA. Sa New York, maingay sila, pero pag nagtanong sila sa'yo, actually, there's concern. Eh. Like, if they ask you how you were, I would always get the sense that they're actually waiting to listen to your reply.
They're really into you. They're interested in what you're gonna say.
Exactly.
But when you're in LA, alam mo that it's thrown like an expression, and you're answering parang they're talking to somebody else already. So sabi ko, that's really a distinction that I get with New York, it's actually easy to ask directions. Maano lang sila, lalo na yung from mga Queens and mga Brooklyn, matigas lang yung accent nila. Pero, at saka parang matapang. Pero ano, they're very, very helpful. I've never really had problems.
Well, sir, ito,
hopefully, I don't have problems.
Okay. Pag nagta-travel ka ba, do you love to shop? Are you a shopper?
Not for me. Because usually, by mga July, I'm done with my Christmas shopping. Kasi when, this is the way I look at things, no? I don't make naman that much. I can't afford to give the extravagant, glamorous gifts that people give. But what I can give is a well-thought-out gift, whether it's mura or mahal. But, you know, it's gonna be customized. Parang if you're going to give candles, for example. some people will shop 100 candles and give that to everybody. I will buy candles, but I will give it to the people I know who like candles. So mas exactly. Mas ganun ako. So
like, for example, when I'm shopping,
like so when I was in Argentina, there were certain things that I saw na, uy, magugustuhan ng friend ko na ganito. Oh, magugustuhan. Ayoko sabihin kasi baka manood sila. Baka malaman nila na nabili ko na yung regalo nila. Tapos, so, and you know, it's not expensive. Pero pag nakita mo, alam mo na, it's something that they will like.
Right? Like, kaysa naman yung, ako sinasabi ko rin yan. Like, tipong, give a gift that it doesn't have to be expensive, but at least something that you thought about that person. Hindi lang na, kinuha mo lang to kasi mahal, or kinuha mo lang to kasi
or
nag-sale.
On a discount or something.
You know that that person would really love it. Like, well, parang, you thought about that person while you're picking that gift. Diba? Ito, ako 1 hour na pala, pasensya na. Pero meron ako, curious lang ako. Do you think like, if you're not doing all these amazing things that you're doing right now, ano tingin mo yung ginagawa mo ngayon? Let's say hindi ka film, hindi ka director, hindi ka...
Traveling? I've always liked to travel. Because to me, I think when I studied in the States when I was 15, it really opened my eyes to a wider perspective. In fact, when I have friends and they tell me that their kids are interested in traveling or it's an option, I always tell them, you know, you should encourage it because it's character building. I think they will have a better worldview. I think they will have a better understanding and tolerance of other people and other cultures. And they will appreciate more things, whether it's in the humanities or on a social level or on a political level, because you do get exposed. So I think it is critical. It is important. And you know, if I, for example, I've always said that if I weren't taking care of family, I would have... Sorry.
Ayan, may ka-chatmate ka na, lumabas.
May ka-chatmate ka na. No, I mean, career-wise.
No, I'm actually surprised it came out because I shut down everything. But I think it was connected to Google. But anyway.
Yeah. I mean, career-wise. I mean, travel blogger ang gusto mong gawin?
No. People have always asked me to do a blog. Sabi ko, I like taking photos and posting it because it's something that I want. If it becomes work, I don't like it anymore. But if I had the chance, I wouldn't want it to be a comic book artist. Because I used to do that when I was younger. I used to draw a lot when I was younger. I wouldn't want it to do that.
Magaling ka pa rin mag-drawing. Hence, the architecture.
Kasi
I took architecture din sa Mapua naman. Saka nag-archi?
UP, Diliman. Tapos diba ang classes ko, nag-uumpisa na 9 o'clock ng gabi. Kasi lahat ng nagtuturo, working professionals, they can only teach at night. Kaya doon ako magtig ng masaksa. Kasi umuwi ata ako ng midnight na. Kaya ako
nag-cheat. Oh, wow. Parang, ano pa ba hindi mo kinakatakutan? Parang natatan experience.
Marami naman akong kinakatakutan. Kaya lang, bakit ka naman magpapatalo sa takot?
Kasi sa multo ba natatakot ka?
Ha?
Sa multo.
Sa multo.
Yung mga hindi natin nakikita.
Conceptually, oo. Pero, depende rin eh. Kasi kung halimbawa, if it's a multo of somebody nakakilala ko and whatever, na alam kong hindi na will not do me harm, parang hindi rin naman. Pero syempre, ako hindi ako nanonood ng ng horror movie in general. Hindi ko gusto. Ay, when I was younger, I used to like it. But when they became slasher movies, sabi ko, nah, it's a little too gory. Yung mga possession, like yung mga The Exorcist, I have to be in the mood to watch something like that. But generally, kaya yung mga Conjuring, hindi ko yun napapanood eh. Kasi parang feeling, paranormal activity, hindi ko rin pinanood. Parang feeling ko, tatakutin ko ba yung sarili ko? Ang dami ko namang genre na gusto. Ang zombies gusto ko. Ang vampira gusto ko. Pero yes, yung mga demonyo, hindi ko gusto.
Oh. Nakakatakot, no? Totoo yan, no? So, meron akong naalala ko nun, maliit pa ako nun, pero pinalabas na siya kasi we love watching mga old movies eh. Kahit na nung 6-8 years old ako, may isa, patayin sa sindak si Barbara.
Well, dalawa yan, di ba? Yung original kay Susan Roses at Rosanna Ortiz. Tapos we've restored the one of Don Zulueta and
Don Zulueta.
Oh, yes. So, yung mga ganun, okay naman sa akin eh. Pero it's just that yung when it's a little too real, parang unang-una magugulatin ako. Eh, parang ano, wala naman akong plano, hindi naman ako malakas magkape, hindi ko naman planong tanggalin ng kape. Pero yung sa akin naman, will I subject myself to something like this? That's why actually, when I watch, and I know that there are mga nakakagulat, I may watch something like The Conjuring, but I will fast forward the jump scares. So that then, I will play back ko na hindi na ako magugulat.
May tactic.
Okay.
Ako ang tactic ko dyan, ano, I watch it, when I watch it alone, I always watch in the afternoon.
Yes, ako din.
Hindi ako nanonood. Usually nanonood ako either afternoon, na maliwanag pa. Pagkatapos, meron akong ibang, ano, meron akong ibang papanoorin after that. Para kumbaga, yun yung naghuhugas ako at saka mawala yung lasa ng horror.
Correct, correct. Oo, do you have any regrets in your life na ginawa mo?
Ako, I always say this. I think, because for many years, I was always offered the chance to work abroad. And I was told that I could actually make it. As in Hollywood.
Oh, yes.
Probably, if I didn't have responsibilities here, na I could afford na just do things on my own. But kasi it's easier if you're not Filipino eh. Pero by ano, ikaw yung nag-aalaga and everything. To me, that's my greatest regret. Because I would have loved to have worked, be an expat and whatever. But that's something that you can do when you don't have too many strings.
I was about to say that. Na kanina pa while you're talking, sabi ko, alam mo, grabe, you're gonna be big in whatever industry that you'll decide.
If you decided
to work in the city, I mean, especially in New York.
No? Kasi kaya ko naman yung ano eh, yung lifestyle at attitude eh, yung mabilis and whatever. Kaya ko naman.
Exactly,
yun.
Exactly.
But you know what?
Hey, you never know. Anything can happen.
I'm probably a little too old. I mean, I'm very pragmatic also when it comes to these things. Like, you can say that, you know, biases aren't there, ageism isn't a reality. But the truth of the matter is, even on a social level, pag halimbawa, ganito na lang, makakita ka ng matanda with a bata, whether male, female, or the reverse, may judgment na kaagad ng karamihan ng mga tao. I try not to have those. But, you know,
yes.
Being human, you do have those. But it does exist. You know that if you'll be considered, you'll be considered maybe as a courtesy, but not as a definite thing. That's why yung sa akin naman, I've always made sure that I was good at my job. I've always made sure that I knew my stuff. Kasi you can have all of these people coming in from college and whatever, and they will have the advantage over technology and some of the other things. But when it comes maybe to how you would put things together and integrate all of the knowledge and whatever, I'd like to say that I can still go toe-to-toe with the best of them.
Are you the type of person, Dio, promise, last na to, last question ko na. promise, I know 1 hour. Wait, 1 minute pa, promise. I'm curious lang, what type of boss are you? Kasi, I mean, I feel like you're...
Naku, yun din yung tatanong ko eh.
Well-spirited na. Di ba, parang, what type of boss are you? Are you the type of boss na...
Stricto ka ba?
Strict and...
Micromanage?
Well, siguro at a certain point, you do need to micromanage. Strict, yes. Pero hindi ako kasi nagagalit. Hindi ako nagmumura. Hindi ako nagagalit. Hindi ako naninigaw. Kasi ang point of view ko dyan is, pag nasabi mo na, hindi mo na mababawi kahit anong sorry. At saka, titimplahin mo naman yung mga tao mo. Eh. If your people are the type that they realize na may mistake, and they already feel about it, what's the point of making them feel worse? That's my attitude toward, that's my attitude in the house and whatever. That's why I do get into arguments because yung iba require a stricter hand. So yung sa akin kasi, sige, nangyari na yan, ganyan. I know you already feel bad. So what are the solutions? That's generally my approach. Kasi yung sa akin, why dwell on the negative? Diba?
True.
Lalo
true.
Na kung halimbawa, yung mga tao ko are conscientious and the mistake is really an innocent mistake. Now, obviously, if it's a glaring mistake, you kind of have to sit them down and explain things why they have to look at it more seriously. But for the most part, I think really, it's a team. Eh. And I never believed in like parang the boss or whatever. Our relationship, we are equals on a personal level. But at the very least, ang titingnan mo lang is the distinction between our posts. As your boss, you do have to give the position the respect for that one. But I will accept arguing with me, especially exactly. On ideas, on concrete solutions and whatever. Because as far as I'm concerned, I do not have a monopoly on good ideas. Somebody will, like for example, Sagip Pelikula was the brainchild of Ian Faustino and whatever. That's why I have never missed the opportunity to give him the credit for that one. And sometimes he would say that, sir, kayo lang yung gumagawa niyan. Pero ang point ko, unang-una ugali ko, never rin naman ako nangangkin ng hindi ko ginawa eh. That's why I'm very, very particular when people take credit for things that we do. So, yun.
At least, oh, di ba? Mukhang masarap, masaya na boss ako. Si ano, Sir Leo.
Oo. Yes, positive. Ako, meron akong last question.
Exactly.
Kay paring Leo.
Last question. Sige, guys. Ayun na yan, si Leo. Go.
Tingnan ko si Leo. Ang cute-cute ni Leo. Anyway. theoretical to. So, Leo, if you were given a chance to travel back in time and talk to your younger self, anong sasabihin mo sa kanya?
Alam mo, offhand, I think, mahirap kasi parang, wala rin naman akong gustong experience na palitan. Probably, I would say that maybe start traveling more, earlier.
Early?
Kasi katulad, I cannot say that, you know, you should chart your own path and go independent and whatever. Because unless magpalit yung scenario mo na wala ka namang mga aalagaan or ano, hindi mo pa rin naman magagawa yun eh. Kasi you would have to completely detach yourself eh. You would really have to say that, no, you know, it's gonna be painful and whatever, no, but I wanna do my own thing. Kayo munang bahala sa buhay niyo. You can't eh. Una-una, it's not also my personality. I've always been taking care of people and whatever. So, kasi even in the house eh, parang the same way I look at our staff in the house, ang feeling ko, I'm responsible for them. They're not just kasambahays and whatever. They're really like family. Mm-hmm. So you always have to look out for them also. Because that's the only way naman that you would also get the loyalty and affection. And to me kasi that's very, very important eh. Pinaka-importante yung mapapagkatiwalaan mo. At saka kung wala ka, sila rin yung mag-aalaga sa magulang mo, sila yung mag-aalaga sa kapatid mo, mag-aalaga sa pamangkin mo, or whoever is there. So to me, that's always very, very important.
So ang hirap makahanap ngayon ng ano, na trustworthy ng makasambahay, no? I mean,
but like for example,
I heard in our house,
Manang Ising has been with us for 69 years. Lynn has been with us for 25 years. So,
oh my God. Ang tagal.
Pamilya na talaga.
Oh, pamilya na talaga. Totoo yan.
Tapos yung iba, may namatay na sa amin and whatever. So you have to look at it that way. You have to treat them also like they are special to you. And to me, that's always been my attitude. Anybody I work with, I will, to the best that I can, I will always treat with respect and dignity and compassion.
Ay, grabe. Imagine and 1 hour and a half. Hindi ka nagagalit agad-agad?
No, dyan hindi ako nagagalit. Kasi parang what's the point eh? Kaya, unang-una, hypertension runs in the family. So kung lagi akong konsumido and whatever, ikamamatay ko pa yan. So, di ba? So it's a matter of having a totally different mindset, I think. You try to do the things that will do that will be good for you. And I think, you know, I've done admirably well with a positive attitude. So, you know, in fact, when I left the cruise in Argentina, I became close with the expedition team. Pagkatapos, one of them, si Anya, was telling me, and even Cathy was telling me, sabi niya, you know, Leo, we are really going to miss you. Alam ko naman na kahit paano may pabalat bunga dun eh. Pero sabi nila, you know, it's just so different that when you would come out, you have this smile and you have this energy that's just infectious, that just cheers us up. And it's not often that we have that. I mean, people are happy. Mm-hmm. Pero yung sa akin, that's my norm. Kasi kahit yung mga Pilipino doon na ano, ako yung nagre-request, kasi 85% of the crew was Filipino eh. Ako yung nagre-request ng sila.
Yes.
Hindi naman sila yung other way around eh. So, and to me, I'm not doing this to make them feel important. It's just something that I like. And I don't discriminate eh. I take photos of the people that I meet or who impact my enjoyment. I mean, if it was somebody I was annoyed with, I wouldn't take a selfie with you. But for the people who were like the person who would be cleaning my room or yung pumapasok pa lang ako, Sir Leo, cook, di ba? Diyan yung gusto mong besa, sige, dadaling ko na dyan. I mean, may mga ganun na treatment na lalapit sila. Anong gusto mo? Huwag ka na tumayo ha, kami na yung kukuha. Di ba? So, I take my selfies with them and whatever. And you know, I don't demand it, I don't ask it. But it's nice also to be told that. So in fact, when I got here, we were messaging. Tapos, one of the expedition team people said, you know, we really still miss you because the cruise has been so different without. So, you know, that even if part of it may have bola, but, you know, why would they go out there?
Good still, yeah.
Something nice.
Grabe. Diba? Alam mo, I cannot wait to meet you in person. Tapos, it will be an honor.
I hope my trip to New York is sooner rather than later.
Yeah.
Like, it doesn't matter anytime this year, next year. Wanna meet in person kasi, J-Cast, it will be an honor, no? Na magkakaroon tayo ng selfie with Mr. Leo. Tapos kasama na tayo dun sa archive niya. Ng mga correct pictures, di ba?
Yun pala yung, parang, yun pala yung plano mo.
Oo. Oo, parang, ay,
gusto ko,
Leo,
gusto ko, I love you, Leo. Oo. I love Leo kasi ano eh, you're a great storyteller. I could listen to you all day.
Oh yes, yes. We've learned so much from you. Ang dami. Para na naman kami nagbasa ng libro. Para na naman kami nagbasa. My God, maraming salamat. My God. Oh, teka po.
Parang I talk too much eh. Parang ano. So good luck na lang kung paano nyo ito i-edit.
Hindi, love it, we love it. Pero sige, 1.5 hours na, you know, sabi nga namin, uy, 1 hour lang daw. Sige na nga, kaso parang bitin nga eh. Di ba, we will continue this when we see you in person in New York.
Yeah.
Any last words? My part two, yes.
Last words, from a personal standpoint, I would suggest that if you guys have the opportunity to travel. If certain opportunities are presented to you, try it at least once so that when you decide that it's not for you, you know why it's not for you. And when it comes to the advocacy, I think, you know, Filipinos are often forgetful of our past and our history. And movies are a great documentation of everything that has happened in the past. And not just what you see on screen, but even what's behind the cameras. Why did the movie work at that time? Why was it a hit and whatever? It tells you of the psychology of the Filipino at that time. So for me, a lot of these movies are a reflection of our identity. They are a record of our history. They have brought us honor even before the current crop of directors and actors have been winning awards. So it would be a shame if we would be forgetting them or just setting them aside. These are movies that have been landmarks in Philippine history. They were important in the lives of our parents, and they could also be important now in your lives if only you'd give yourselves a chance to enjoy them and to appreciate them. So to the extent that you can, hopefully you will get to appreciate and enjoy the classic movies that we've been restoring, and hopefully fall in love with them the same way that we have fallen in love with them, and make sure that the people in the past who have contributed so much to this industry are not forgotten and forever remembered.
Yeah.
Wow, that was a good.
That's very
last
profound.
Message.
Wow.
Very profound and precise. I know. Pero invite them. Don't forget to.
Pawis mo ata dapat nandito, hindi na sa ibabaw.
Oh. Invite them also sa best
the
of
best.
The bets.
Yes.
Yes.
And watch Best 10 Bets. I know my choices may not always reflect your choices, but it is a fun show, and what we're trying to do there is give you a little more background and information on the stories behind the choices, and a lot of them are probably unheard of. So at least those were anecdotes that we heard directly from the people concerned or from those very much connected with them. So,
and it's a great concept. I don't think there's a lot of Filipino countdown or best of
exactly
shows. So
it's been a segment in some other shows, but never a full-blown show.
Yeah, yun so, nga eh.
Oo nga, galing. Yeah. Oh, good luck. We're so excited. Ma-meet ka talaga in person. I cannot wait.
And hopefully you come up with your own list and your opinions, and it's something that you share in the threads and whatever. Because generally, that's what we want naman eh. That it will spark conversation and people will have their own lists. Not necessarily the same as our own list, because it really depends on your exposure. If you're younger, you'd be more familiar with the younger stars. If you're older, you'd probably have a larger list. If you're older and don't watch the new one, then you'll have an old list. So
exactly.
So, but at least it sparks interesting discourse. It could be conversation over money and wine.
Oh, I love that.
Manina, ano? Time while waiting for your friends to arrive in the bars in Manhattan. So,
ayaw ko niya mani. Okay.
I love mani. Ay!
Pwede ba ano? Hot dog and wine. Ayun yung ganito yung masisling hot dog eh.
Chocolate o Hungarian sausage?
Exactly. Vienna?
Gusto ko yan. Diba? Inog Slovenia tayo. Ano yan? Oh my God, we love the sausages with horseradish. Oh my God, nagutom na naman ako.
So you went to Ljubljana? I also went there last year.
Yeah, with Ljubljana. Oh my God,
yes. Last year.
Tapos lang ako from Trieste to Slovenia. To Ljubljana.
Really? Diba?
Parang kung magbiyahe ako, akala mo bata pa ako. Sabi ko, my God, sir, I am getting way too old for this.
Alam mo, sa future nga, magsama tayo sa ano, kasi we travel too, we love to travel. Kaming tatlo, oh my God, always. So parang, and we love to be with friends who loves to travel too. Kasi yung iba, pag kasama mo kasi hindi mahilig mag-travel.
Argentina, so I love the tango. And I love the food. Yeah. Kahit ang hamburger nila, mas masarap pa sa Wagyu na binibenta dito. Kasi specialty nila, karne. So ano, sabi ko nga, para namang mag-aano lang ako, mag-franchise. Kasi franchise siya eh. Pero papunta ko, ang sarap ng burger nila. Ibang klase yung karne.
Oh my so, God, naginuto mo ako. Nagutom ako bigla.
At saka diba, sweets sila, yung dulce de leche nila. Kasi hindi ako mag-dessert. Pero ang sarap-sarap ng dulce de leche nila. And you should try the dulce de leche with wine. That is so good.
Oh, really? Naku, direct ha? Direct. May mahilig sa sweets si direct eh.
Akin, kasi ang bilis hindi ko gusto eh. Nung pinatikim sa akin, sabi ko, uy, masarap siya.
Wow! Ano mo? Pati travel tips, no? Natutunan natin. Ako, maraming salamat. I know na kinain namin ng more than one and a half hours mo, pero maraming salamat talaga for great
information. I actually allotted 2 hours for you, just so you know.
Oh, ah, diba? Talaga?
Ano ka ba, planner yan?
Thank you. Oh. I know, planner nga. Oo. Kaya mukhang pag mag kaya, sa future, ha.
Mas mahirap pa mag-edit out ng isang oras kesa.
I know, right? Kasi yun lang kami. Sabi nga namin sa TFC, bakit 1 hour lang allowed? Sabi, ayun lang talaga, sige, sayang. So direct, bahala na kayo mag-edit.
Pag kailangan nyo ng filler.
I know, right?
O sila mag-edit niyan.
Alam mo, I have an idea. Pagdating mo dito, let's have like a sit down habang whatever, umiinom, kumakain, kwentuhan, no? Parang wala lang, kwentuhan lang while filming. Si Direk ang bahala doon.
You're on WhatsApp.
Yes, of course.
Yeah, we have WhatsApp.
If sina Noella have your numbers, I'll get it from them na.
Oh, yes. Yes, ha. Promise,
ayan.
Ha.
Ayan. Yes. Oh, my God.
Basta nasa kanila, message you. We can have a WhatsApp.
Yeah. I feel social na. BFF na ako ni Leo.
I know, rubbing elbows na tayo with Leo.
One of the things that I always get surprised with, kasi I never view myself naman as anything. I just see myself as ordinary and whatnot, whether you believe it or not. Kaya yung sa akin, I do get flattered when I hear comments like that. But generally, it's just parang like in the course of making new friends and meeting people and whatever, there's really nothing different. Ganun rin lang siya.
Ang galing. You know what? Keep it that way. That's why, alam mo, lalove kita lalo ngayon kasi you're so humble. Yung iba, hindi.
Yeah. Ay, naku, hindi.
6 years na akong ganyan. So palagay ko, hindi na rin naman siya magbabago.
Wait. Naku, Anuela, ha? Naku, at saka MK. Yan, kukunin ko na yung number mo kaagad, ha?
Gawin na yung ano, WhatsApp group na yan. Gawa na ng name yan.
Yes! Diba? Yes! Maraming salamat, Sir Leo. JCast, come on. Close our podcast for this morning. Go ahead.
Yes. Thank you for mga kaugat for tuning in. And don't forget to share this amongst your family and friends. Thank you sa buong mundo, sa mga subscribers natin sa The Filipino Channel. And also to everyone who's watching the FYE channel as well. And also, huwag natin kalimutan ng mga pasahero natin sa Jeepney TV, 'di ba? At saka of course sa iWant TFC app din pwede tayong stream. Oh my God.
Yes.
Leo, Sir Leo, thank you so much for for hanging out with us and for the great conversation and kwentuhan. Ayan.
Yes,
ano tayo, guys?
I enjoyed myself.
And see you soon. Okay. See you soon sa New York. Magano tayo mag-last toast tayo this morning, guys.
Yes,
everybody and Leo, amidst the challenges of life, let's still find ways to be happy. Let's all talk about it
over a glass or two.
Thank you.
Good morning.
See you soon.
Bye, Sir Leo.